I was on my way to Lebanon, minding my own business, when I heard something on the airplane TV.
What do you want me to say? He's way back, he is not the greatest FIFA player.
Zidane, it's kind of messed up that you're saying that, but I'm gonna have to agree with you there. I'm not the best.
Knock, knock! Who's there? PK! PK who? Peekaboo's ways that Shakira's a fast babe! But I have to say in this interview that Zwei does not know how to do a real dump kick.
Wait, what?
Ito!
Yes?
Where are we, bro?
We are flying over Algeria.
Land the plane, bro!
It's time for me to show Zidane my dump kick.
Show Zidane, you're making fun of me, but I know that I'm right. I'ma do whatever I want, I'm gonna dump kick all night.
I'm trying to get the Boufal El Shaarawy look. Did I nail it? That's sick.
What's happening, boys, and welcome to the Algerian Zidane and the alternate Algeria squad at the Celtic.
What's up, bros, and welcome to the alternate Algeria squad builder episode. Now, as you guys can guess by the thumbnail, this is going to feature one of the most famous French footballers of all time, but also a little bit controversial because you have this dichotomy. Great SAT word, by the way. Not 100% sure what it means, but I think I used it correctly there. So I was inspired to do this epi by a Reddit thread that I saw called the Other French National Team, aka the Other Algerian Side. Now, basically, the premise of it was it showcased a bunch of players that play for the French national team that also could qualify to play for Algeria, whether they have Algerian descent through their mother or father, and in some instances both, but they grew up in France and they usually choose to play for the blue, white, and red. The most famous name, obviously, is Zinedine Zidane. Played his full career at the for the French national team. And the most recent one is gonna be Karim Benzema. Now, he got under a little bit of fire for saying something along the lines of Algeria is my country, and he can say whatever he wants. Anyone can say whatever they want. Algeria is his country and France is just where he plays. So he got a little bit under fire for that one. Obviously does have Algerian descent, so he is eligible to play for the Algerian national team. The next one is Mbappe Lotin, whose mother, Faiza, is actually Algerian. So Mbappe Lotin, aka Mbappe Lotion, eligible to play for the Algerian national team. So far we have Benzema and Mbappe Lotin, one of the most exciting young talents in football period, not just French or in Europe, but in the world period. So Mbappe Lotin, Karim Benzema are the first two. We're gonna go into the big screen format here and show you guys also Nabil Fekir. He got probably the most criticized of the three players. I don't think Mbappe Lotin has anything that had come towards him. Benzema had made a couple statements, but Nabil Fekir actually declared playing, I believe, for Algeria, then went back because he was pressured by the French Association and then also Lyon to stay and play for the French national team. So we have the three of Nabil Fekir, Benzema, Mbappe Lotin, three incredible players. Samir Nasri, aka Drip Doctors, also has Algerian descent, but what we're going to do in this episode is we're going to replace Valbuena with Mahrez. Once we get in game, we're going to take Hani and bring him on for Nasri, and then we're going to take Mehdi Benatia, whose mother is Algerian, but he decided to play for his father's Morocco. We're going to use his 84 inform and replace Medjani. We've got ourselves Zafain, we've got Mandi, we've got Mboholi. I believe he's the second Algerian keeper in the game. There's not a higher rated keeper than 69. Unfortunately, we wanted to try and get a little bit better. And then we've got Goulam for Napoli, we've got Boudabouz. If you guys think this is a cool idea for an epi, if you guys have any other ideas for some other nationalities, for example, I know Turkey, there's Kadira and Özil. Obviously, those are players that would be eligible to play for the Turkish national side. Let me know if there's some cool sides and maybe build out a starting 11 in the comments, or give me some names or some nations that I could do similar to this one. But hopefully you guys do enjoy the concept. If you guys do enjoy the epi, if you guys want to see more, hit that like button as well. If you guys are new to the channel, hit that subscribe button down below. Instagram and Twitter links can be found there as well. Let's get to match number one. Let's see if we can take this alternate Algeria side and actually do some damage. Because there's no Algerian kit in FIFA, we're going with the Cork City in the Irish League, just because they have the Clonakilty sausages. They have a sausage company on the front of their kit. They also have green and white, which is obviously the colors for the Algerian national team. He's got himself the 84 footy Smalling. I'm not sure why he doesn't have the 87. He's got himself the 82 Butland, and I am wearing the Portugal kit just because it is the closest thing that I own to the actual Algerian national side. But we've got Zinedine Zidane in there as our manager. Let's see if we can make some subs. Let's see if we can actually tear it up. What did my mom do in her life that I ended up like this? John? And that is game over, son. 1-0 in the 6th minute. You know when you're just in the first 10 minutes of the match and you just feel like you've outclassed your opponent? Now, I've said it before and I've actually lost, but I feel like we've got this one in the bag. Now, doing this epi got me thinking to a personal issue that I have, which is the fact that my dad is German and then my mom is from California, so she's obviously here in America. Now, if I was actually a good footballer, if I actually had talent to play, as you guys have seen in the in real life football videos, I don't. But if I had to make a choice, I don't know what I would do, to be honest with you. Like, my dad raised me supporting the German national team. Again, I've said it in videos, you guys will know it. I've said it before, one of my first ever memories is the 1990 World Cup. So I really have lived through two German World Cup victories. Don't remember the 1991, but it is one of my like first vague memories. I just remember my parents like jumping up and down. We had a huge party at the house in Germany. But it got me thinking, you know what I mean? Like, I've grown up in the United States, and this is my home. But I support the German national team, so if push came to shove, what would I do? Would I side for the German side because I have the dual nationality, I have German and American citizenship, and maybe have a better chance at winning a World Cup ring or some trophies, a Confed Cup or something like that? I feel like, I feel like I could actually star in a World... I could star in a Confed Cup match. That's the bar! Let's go! Let's go, 2-0! Yo, Mbappe, Algerian Mbappe Le Pen! The Mbappe Lutin hat trick off the crossbar. He is winning the hat trick challenge. 35 minutes in and he's already got 3 goals. Come on.
Oh, that's risky. Damn. And it's spawning here to Mbappe. Can he seal it now?
Mbappe Lutin!
Oh, what an accomplishment! 4-0!
What is going on, boys? All right, we're gonna concede one. All right, well, in Foot Champs qualification, you're gonna concede at least one. Match number one with the Altern Algeria squad, and it is a decisive victory. Mbappe Le Pen gets himself 3 goals. Technically should have been 4. I think the Jack Butland one counted as an own goal. A 4-1 victory in match number one. Let's see if we can continue that match number two. 17 shots, 12 on target. Just decimated. Match number two, he's got Sanchez, he's got 84 Walcott, and he's also got Neymarcito. 1, 2, 3, 4. Oh, now I get it. Dude, come on, bro. Dude. Mbappe! 1-1! Dude, where was this Mbappe when I used him the first time? He did not light it up like this. Oh, Nabil Fekir! 2-1! In a matter of seconds, we have turned it around. We were down 1-0, 38th minute. Go up 2-1, Nabil Fekir. That's the one thing about the 4-3-3. Leaves you very, very vulnerable defensively. Oof, good defensive play. Come on, our goal's coming up right here. Freaked out, maybe tried an errant pass over to Mbappe who was making the run, but we play it cool and slot it in top right with our main man, league mate Buda Boost. Come on. Yes, there we go, match number two. Got a little scary there, conceded very early. Kind of a fluky goal. Benatia literally splits his nuts open. 6 shots, 4 on target for him, 5 shots, 4 on target for me. Incredibly, incredibly even match. Came right down to the last minute. 83rd goal from Buda Boost was the difference. Let's get to match number 3. Los Gates. Third match, he's got Martial, he's got Coutinho, and he's got Vardy Party. Whew. Bro, Ghulam is just insane. Gone. still in, but it counts because he is of Algerian descent. So that still counts. Bro, I'm not even kidding you. Anytime I do a series or I do an episode where I have to bring on a sub, it turns out that the starter that's coming off always scores. Whew. Ghulam, honestly, has maybe been the hero of the episode so far. Booty! Booty, booty! Woohoo! Come on, he gets us the winner in the last match, possibly the winner in this one, 35 minutes. Still plenty of time left in this one, though. Anything could happen. Incidental contact. I'm gonna slide. I'm saving this. I know I'm gonna get this. You know, I rate Mboli just for the fact that I went right, and by default he went left.
Oh, a kick now turned Pac inside out.
One night stand.
Oh my God! Oh my God! Unbelievable!
What athleticism by Bobby Lashley! Oh my God!
Is this really what we're dealing with right now? Woohoo! Riyad Mahrez! Just juking dudes out of their pants!
What on earth is he doing?
Wait a second. You wanna know what I truly believe? I believe there's a jar. You know on Twitch how there's the tip jar? I truly believe there's a karma jar in FIFA that stacks up all the bad things that happen to you in FIFA. And then once it gets to the tippy top, something good will happen to you in a match that you probably didn't deserve. I didn't deserve that goal. Riyad Mahrez is second. I just don't know what just happened there. Wait. And there you have it, boys! The third and final match. Both of the last two matches had their dark periods where we went down, but we managed to rally with this Altern Algeria side. Boudibouz again, one goal. Mahrez steps up in this one, gets us the victory, and then the combo, the trio of Mbappe, Lotin, Fekir, and Boudibouz also get the hat trick. So I would say Mbappe, Lotin, probably the star of the epi. Ghulam was right there, obviously not providing assist or scoring goals, but just had the entire left side locked down. No matter if it was Neymar or anyone, they were not able to get down on his side of the pitch. Benatia was good. Mandi was a little bit of a liability. Zephine was solid. Mboli, for being a 69-rated silver keeper, was very, very impressive. But no question about it, Mbappe Lutin was the star of the epi alongside Boudibouz and Nabil Fekir. Again, Mahrez stepped up towards the end. But that is going to be the Altern Algeria squad. Hopefully you guys did enjoy. Like I asked at the beginning, give me some other countries and some other stipulations that I can do like I did with this Altern Algeria side. Again, like Turkey or some other nations that I'm not thinking of. Let me know in the comment section below. Hopefully you guys did enjoy. If you did, hit that like button. If you guys are new to the channel, hit that subscribe button down below. I will see you guys for another upload tomorrow. Till next time, boys, tschüss, later, adieu.